All right, students, so we're gonna dissect the heart today. And remember to orient yourself externally. We talked about that previously. And now I'm gonna have my heart oriented to me. We have the right ventricle here, left auricle, right auricle. I'm gonna do a 90 degree turn. And I'm doing this because when I make my, I'm gonna cut through the flow, the way the blood flows throughout the heart. And so I'm gonna start in my right atrium to my right ventricle. And then I'm gonna make an incision up and out the pulmonic trunk. So this is really important to be able to follow that pathway of blood flow. So again, when you are cutting, you wanna be very careful that you do not cut yourself. So I'm gonna make an incision from the left auricle, right auricle down. And again, I'll probably have to extend this. I'm gonna go down into the right ventricle. And I didn't push very hard because I wanna be able to make sure I don't go too far through this. And then I can extend my incision with scissors, cutting this way. And that way I minimize the risk of cutting myself or my lab partners. So here you can see I've made an incision in the right atrium down through the right AV valve into the right ventricle. So a couple of structures we want to point out. One, the smoothness of this endocardium. So this is that smooth tissue here, and this is lining the heart and it's contiguous with the vessels, right? The endothelium of the endocardium is contiguous with the vessels that we have. We have superior vena cava coming in here. We have inferior vena cava coming into the right atrium here. And then we have our right AV valve. I'm gonna cut through that just so you can see it a little bit better. And you can appreciate when we look at these valves, they have flaps, we call these cusps, and these cusps are anchored by these little cords here. These cords are called chordae tendinae, and they are anchored to these swellings here, the papillary muscles. So these muscles right here anchor the chordae tendinae and the cusps of the vessels. And the importance of this is we want blood to flow one way. So as blood empties into the, drips down from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava into the atrium, this is going to be open and blood is gonna flow into the right ventricle. When the atria contracts, it's going to squeeze blood into the ventricle. As the ventricle starts to contract, blood is gonna be pushed up and these chordae tendinae anchor the cusps, so this seals and prevents backflow of the blood. Very, very important. So again, you need to know these structures, right atrium, right auricle, the cusps here to our right AV valve, and remember the AV valves are the ones that have the chordae tendinae and are anchored to these papillary muscles. Okay, and this is my right ventricle. Another name for this valve is, so right AV valve or tricuspid valve. It's called the tricuspid because it actually has three flaps. So three flaps, that's why it's named the tricuspid. Now, this is a unique, the right ventricle is unique in that it kind of wraps around the left ventricle like this. So the actual outflow of this ventricle is going to be up and out the pulmonic trunk. So I'm actually gonna make an incision this way towards my pulmonic trunk so we can see the flow of the blood up and out. And I'll probably just use my scissors to make, to cut this way so I can follow this pathway up to the pulmonic trunk. Now you can do this with your scalpel handle. Just be careful that you isolate the heart really well and it's not moving and you don't slip to cut yourself. So here I've reached my pulmonic trunk here. And remember there's a valve from the right ventricle to the pulmonic trunk. This is what I call my pulmonic valve. You can actually see some bloody tissue in here, so it's a little bit hard to see. But the pulmonic valve is gonna be this semilunar valve that's sitting right here. And these are little flaps, And the significance of this valve is that as blood flows out, it pushes the flaps against the wall. But then when blood tries to flow back down, because of the high pressure in this vessel and because of gravity, as it tries to flow down, those cusps are going to balloon out and catch that blood and prevent backflow into the ventricle. So this is very important for that one-way blood flow that we talked about. So you can see here, this is all the right ventricle here of the heart. And again, we went through the direction of the blood flow to the pulmonic trunk. Now the pulmonic trunk is going to divide, and it's going to divide into pulmonary arteries. Remember, arteries go away from the heart. Those will go to the lungs. We're going to pick up oxygen, and we're going to return to the left side of the heart. So again, let's orient right side, left side. I'm going to turn it this way, and I can actually see my pulmonic veins emptying here into the left atrium slash auricle. That's my left auricle. So now I'm going to make an incision down from the left auricle down into the left ventricle. Okay. And when I do this again, you want to be very careful that you are kind of anchoring your heart, and I'm going to cut down in here. And remember, the left ventricle is much thicker than the right ventricle. So I might have to extend this cut a little bit more because this is much thicker. Okay. Wow, you can really see the difference in the size of this ventricular free wall here. It is much bigger than the right side. So if I open this up, again, here is my left atrium, left auricle here. And remember, my pulmonary vein right here coming in. This is my left AV valve. Now this one has two cusps, so it's also named the bicuspid. And it has a third name, the mitral valve. You might hear that most commonly. So it is important to know all three names. And I think it's important to appreciate that you want to, when you're first learning this, always say AV valve so you can picture the type of valve this is. And remember, AV valve tells you where it is, atrium to ventricle. And remember, these types of valves have the cusps and the chordae tendineae and the papillary muscles here. So this is my left atrium. This is my left AV valve, mitral or bicuspid, and then this is my left ventricle. So blood is going to flow from left atrium through the left AV valve to the left ventricle. And then as this left ventricle squeezes, it's going to shut this left AV valve, and blood is going to be pushed up and out right through this area here, and that's actually your aortic valve. So this is going to go into the aorta. So I'm going to show you with my finger. Here's my, you can actually see my finger right there, and I'm going up, and this is out the aorta. So if you weren't sure which vessels were which, you can definitely appreciate that this is coming from the left ventricle. And that valve right there, that's a great example of a semilunar valve down in there, and that is our left semilunar or aortic valve. And again, you want to say to yourself semilunar so you remember what type of valve it is. So that is the blood flow through the heart, right atrium to right ventricle, through that right AV valve, out the pulmonic trunk, to the lungs, pick up oxygen, come back through the pulmonary veins, into left atrium, through left AV valve, left ventricle, and then out the aortic valve, or left semilunar, to the aorta, and then out to the rest of the body. Okay? Now appreciate there are some vessels you see here on the outside of the heart. These are the coronary vessels, and these will come off the aorta very early on to supply the actual muscle of the heart, the tissues of the heart, with oxygen. The heart does not get any nutrients and oxygen as it's flowing through the lumen here. So as we flow through the chambers, no nutrition for the heart. This is actually what's providing the nutrition for the heart.